आई एम संतोष गायधनकर. टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द इकोनॉमी. इन दिस टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द डिक्लाइन मेथड ऑफ द डिप्रिसिएशन मेथड टू. इन द लेक्चर वन वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द स्ट्रेट लाइन मेथड. इन दिस मेथड सेज दैट इन दिस मेथड ऑफ डिप्रिसिएशन ए कॉन्स्टेंट परसेंटेज ऑफ बुक वैल्यू ऑफ द प्रीवियस पीरियड ऑफ द एसेट विल बी चार्ज एज अ डिप्रिसिएशन अमाउंट फॉर द करेंट पीरियड. A fixed percentage is charged to the rate of the depreciation amount. It may be 2%, 3%, or 0.2%, or 0.5%. This approach is more realistic approach since the depreciation charges are decreases with the life of the asset. Here, what happened? The depreciation will be decreases with respect to life of the asset, but in the case of straight line method, it was remain constant as 10,000 rupees throughout the life of the asset. And matches with the earning of the potential of the asset. If you add it, it will matches to the initial cost. The book value of the at the end of the life of the asset may not be exactly equal to the salvage value. Here what happened? The salvage value in the last case in the straight line method, the salvage value was 20,000 and the book value at the end of 8th year it is 20,000, but here the salvage value is not exactly to that of the as exactly to that of the a given salvage value. This is the major limitation of this approach. Now, where here P is nothing but the first cost of the asset. P is the first cost of the asset. S is the salvage value of the asset. N is the life of the asset. B, T is nothing but the book value of the asset at the end of the period T. K is nothing but a fixed percentage, and DT is nothing the depreciation amount at the end of the period T. This is the formula for depreciation and the book value of the following, and these are used for the table formula. DT is equal to K into BT minus 1, and BT is equal to BT minus 1 minus DT, or 1 minus K into BT minus 1. Or you can use this formula directly. This is used for the table, and you can use for directly this one. DT is nothing but K into 1 minus K raised to T minus 1 into P, or BT is equal to 1 minus K raised to T into P, or use this formula. Or if the K is not given, then you have to use this formula. K is equal to 1 minus S divided by P raised to 1 by N. Or in the case of S, you have to substitute the F also. This is the decline balance method. In the exam, if they ask for the double decline balancing method, then in the place of K, you have to write as a 200% of N. N is nothing but the life of the asset. This is the concept. Now we are solving the problem based upon this concept. Now this is the problem. This is a double decline. This is the declining balancing method of depreciation. This is the table formula. And I will consider the same problem as the lecture one, where P is nothing but 1 lakh and the salvage value or F value is 20,000, and assuming K is equal to 0.2. If you want to find out the K, you have to use this formula. K is nothing but 1 minus S divided by P raised to 1 by N, where S is nothing but F here. Now, I am solving this problem. At 0, the depreciation will be nothing. 1 lakh rupees. Go for the booking value. At 1, the depreciation value will be 0.2 into 1 lakh based on this formula. 1 lakh is nothing but answer will be 20,000. If you minus with this one, 1 lakh minus 20,000, you will get what? 80,000. Similarly, for 2, end of the period 2, 0.2 into 80,000, you will get what? 16,000. 16,000 minus this one, you will get what? 64,000. For third, 0.2 into 64,000, you will get 12800. If you minus in this and this, you will get what? 51200. For fourth, again 0.2 into 51 into 51200. Answer will be 10240. For this one, 040960. For fifth, 0.28192. Minus this and this, you will get 32768. For sixth, 655 3.6. Answer for this one is nothing but 26214.4. For seventh, 0.2 multiply with 0.2, you will get 5242.88. Minus this and this, you will get 20971.52. For eighth, because in our problem we are considering for n is equal to 8, as the lecture one, as the bit of the lecture one. In the 8th, 0.2 into this one is nothing but 4194.30, and this one will be 16777.22. If you add this one, the total will be 8222.78, and if you add this one with this, the answer will be 1 lakh. Answer with 1 lakh. Now, as per the explanation, now this is the explanation they have said it. This is the explanation they have said it. See here, the depreciation amount, depreciation charges decreases with the life of the asset. Here, the depreciation amount was continuously decreases with the life of the asset. First condition is over. Next, the earning potential of the asset, the book value at the end of the life of the asset may not be equal to the exact value of the salvage value. Salvage value, the salvage value is here 20,000. It is not equal to that of the 20,000. It is 16,777.22, but our salvage value is 20,000. Next, measure. Okay, excellent. Next, now if you add this one, you will get my some value. If you add this value with this one, you will get the same 1 lakh rupees. Now how to solve directly is an important one here. In exam, if they ask for end of the period fifth and find out the depreciation for fifth, just d5 substitute d5 k is already known, 0.2 into 1 minus 0.2 into 5 minus 1 into p is nothing but 1 lakh. Your answer will be 8192, similar to this one. It is also 8192. Now for book value, b5, 1 minus 0.2 raised to 5 into 1 lakh. The answer will be 32768. Now similar to this, for DT 1892, for BT 32768. This is the direct method. You can use, go for either this one or this one, you will get the same answer. One thing you have to remember is the thing, but if k is not given, then use this formula for declining balancing method. In the case of double declining balance method, you have to use k is equal to 200% of n. This is the double declining balance method. In number of problems, they will ask the double decline balancing method. either you can go for the table one or you can go for this using this formula. You will get the same result. I am Santosh Gadankar. Thank you very much.